Blue-green algae are suddenly an important consideration in Kansas recreational waters. These algae, a type of bacteria that mimics higher plants in the way they photosynthesize food, can produce toxins dangerous to humans and animals that come into direct contact with water. Blue-green algae exist naturally in our waters, but hot and sunny conditions sometimes create population explosions or blooms in nutrient-rich waters. When toxins are produced, unsafe conditions can last for days or months, with adverse effects on recreational visits and local economies. The Kansas Department of Health and Environment monitors blue-green algae and posts warnings and advisories for Kansas public waters. Currently, 13 lakes and reservoirs have warnings or advisories. Further details and listings are available on the Kansas Wildlife Parks and Tourism website. For the first time, a new Kansas strategy is being tried to prevent buildups of blue-green algae at the 83-acre Meade State Fishing Lake. Located in southwest Kansas, just 13 miles southwest of Meade, the popular lake is home to Meade State Park. This lake was shut down to public use through much of last year by blue-green algae. A Clean Water Neighbor grant, provided through EPA Section 319 funding and secured through Kansas Department of Health and Environment, was awarded this year. Now, a test project is underway that may help reduce blue-green algae production by reducing dissolved nutrients needed for their growth. The experiment created floating islands of plants to utilize excessive nitrogen and phosphorus in the lake. Using foam mats pre-cut to accept individual cups, special plants grown and conditioned for more than a year were placed with roots in the water. As these grow, they develop massive root systems that naturally filter the water. Reducing excessive nutrients makes it less likely that blue-green algae can grow. Two islands totaling more than 3,000 square feet were assembled and planted with 8,000 plants in the study. Blue flag iris and soft rush were mixed 1-to-1. The floating islands were placed into wire pens to prevent unwanted grazing by fish and animals. Overall, visual and recreational impacts are minimal. This aggressive test project, conceived and coordinated through Meade State Park manager Matthew Trujillo, required several days and more than a dozen staff and volunteers to complete. Plants were purchased from Applied Ecological Services in Baldwin City. Westar Energy and Kansas Department of Health and Environment also provided support for the experiment. Plant and water samples will be monitored monthly and chemically analyzed for nutrient uptake. This fall, the plants will be harvested. If the experiment works as hoped, it may provide a natural means to help reduce blue-green algae in small impoundments or coves of larger reservoirs throughout Kansas. I'm Mike Blair for Kansas Wildlife Parks and Tourism.